Hi guys, welcome back to The View with your girl Ola Dunni. Thank you for joining us again. And have you subscribed? Do that now. And also turn on the notification bell so you get our videos first once we upload. I know you're looking at the fine brother that is sitting beside me. You're wondering that, Dunni, how do you get there? It's a story for another day. I'm the king of boys. So with me here, I have Blessing. He is a photographer. One of Akure's finest photographers. Introduce yourself now, don't be shy.
Hi guys, my name is Blessing. But let's call myself Ejor. I don't know why everyone calls me Blessing.
Because Blessing is king, dog. He prefers to call himself Ejor. He's a Calabar boy. He's a Calabar boy. And you should follow him on Instagram at Ejor Bissong. You'll be thrilled. Is it this fine brother that took all the pictures? Trust me, his work is amazing. I can't sing to save my soul. So today we're going to be talking about a very interesting topic. Blessing, do you want to tell them? I should tell them the topic. Don't worry, we already will see it already, but let Blessing just tell you.
So today the topic is, are you your type?
Okay, initially when I met Blessing, let me just tell everybody. Blessing was my crush. He used to be my crush when I first met him, because, you know, we even went to the same university, though he was my senior. We finished from university, and you know, later on we just became friends and the crush, you know how these things work. And now I'm reflecting on the question, am I my type's type? Then I was liking Blessing. Was I your type?
Should I say the truth? Well, not entirely.
Exactly. It wasn't my type, because when I realized that, what am I crushing on in the... No offense, but then it wasn't really my type. It wasn't what I actually have in my bucket list for a, is it boyfriend, I'll call it, and I wasn't what he wanted. So when we talk about are you your type's type, there is this chart I saw on Instagram, I think, and it goes between a guy and a girl, Henry or so. I've read it to Bless. I'm going to read it to us now. Hey, that's the guy. Then the girl says, why don't you introduce me to one of your friends? I want a handsome and rich one. He must have a car. Then the guy replies, amazingly, all my friends are rich, handsome, and they all drive. But the thing is, they only want beautiful rich girls who drive also. No, Henry, now that's the girl. That's rude. Why would you say that? And the guy replies with something that we are going to dwell on. My dear, this is 2020. We must be a reflection of what we want from life. And seeing our first example, I had a crush on Blessing, but I realized that I wasn't a reflection of what he wants from life, and he wasn't even a reflection of what I wanted from life. Yes, it's my friend, we are cool friends, we are partners at work and stuff. But are you a reflection of what you want from life? Blessing, what do you think about that statement?
Well, first, I think as humans, we should always try to understand that we are selfish beings.
Selfish.
That's the truth. And as life goes on, when we go to school, we grow, we meet people, we start one or two businesses and all of that, or whatever we do, we should always have it in mind that human beings are selfish, and for every reason, or for whatever, or every reason, we would always want to go for what we want.
Yes.
Whether you tell yourself you are the modest guy, humble, and all of that, you would always find that deep down, if you search within yourself, you find that you always want to put yourself first.
First
within anything you do. So that's the thing. So when you, but you know, when it comes to this issue of the boy-girl thing, we don't really analyze it that way. So we don't really put ourselves first. I think we put the other person first. So that's where the whole issue comes to play. You get, so like, is it, are you your type style? Do you guys like the same thing? Are you similar interests?
Yeah.
These are the questions you should ask yourself. Does she like
the things
I like and all of that? Yeah. So the questions you should ask yourself. But now, I think most of the time we're just blinded by the things that we just see with the other eye, like I think in that chat we talked, the girl
cars.
Talked about cars.
You must be rich.
It's okay. And that.
Yeah.
Fine. I know. In fact, I don't want to be with a broke girl.
Me too. I don't want to be with a broke guy.
And I don't want my sister to be with a broke guy.
And I don't want my brother. I don't have a brother though to be with a broke girl.
But then, as humans, there are a lot of other things that we should
need to
look out for before we. Well, of course, definitely. There's no other way to know these things if you do not interact with yourself, you don't go out
exactly.
And all of that. So like, then when you put these things like cars, was it the reaching first? You are already breaking every relationship that might or can
be built. I personally feel that when you have a bucket list for a relationship, your first thing shouldn't be car, money, house. Mm-hmm. Come on, those things would happen. What if he has car and he does not have sense? And the boys out there these days, and even the girls out there these days. Most of us don't have sense. So the first thing you should
I have sense.
Me instead, come on, we're just saying. But first thing you should look at is, do we like the same things? Am I a reflection of, is he a reflection of what I want? Am I a reflection of what he wants? I can't just want, you can't want Dangote's son. Oh, baby Dangote, baby Otedola, rich and stuff like that. And you are lazy. You are the type that, you're a girl that you still sleep by 9 and you're still dreaming. How can you be dreaming by 9? How will you be sleeping by 9? You're still dreaming.
Well, I think I should come in there. Now, this is one of the things we're talking about. In some way, I think we are there to complement each other.
Exactly.
So now you going back to, you said, okay, you want to go for a Dangote's guy, kind of guy.
And you're not, what's her name? Alakija.
But I don't, now that's where it comes, I don't think those things should restrict us from knowing ourselves first.
They shouldn't. You can't just be wishing for a baby Dangote and then your baby.
Well, I think sometimes wishes come true. Yes. And that is just,
If wishes were us, it's beggars will write. See, if it's for me to wish to date Dangote's son, I used to say that if Dangote come and tell me that I want to marry, and my father said, you can't marry a Muslim. Daddy, I can't marry a Muslim.
Yes,
you're just the one that is thinking it. I can't marry it's not Dangote. Even my daddy girl will tell me that she married Dangote. But really, before you can crave to marry the next Dangote, the next Bill Gates, what are you doing with yourself? Are you working on yourself? You can't just have a bucket list that, oh, you must be rich, you must be... Are you actually planning to be dependent in this relationship? He must be handsome. Okay, a handsome guy wants to marry a fine girl. Are you fine? Are you working on your beauty? See, beauty is in the eye of the beholder. What do you do? Are you the type of person that you are nonchalant about the cream you use? You are nonchalant about the soap you use? You can use the same soap to wash your pants, same soap to wash your, to brush your teeth, have your bath and do everything. Are you the type of guy that you are tacky, you can't keep your house neat, and you want a hardworking girl? Are you trying to date a slave? You want somebody that will come and be cleaning your house and washing your towel and duvet? Brother, if you are lazy, you deserve a lazy girl. You would, can you see? You wouldn't mind. So before you want something, be that thing. Can you date you? If you were the other, the opposite sex, can you date yourself? Ask yourself that question. Blessing, if you're a girl, can you date you? If you say yes.
Right now. Well, I'm getting a lot of advances from beautiful ladies. For real, I'm getting a lot of advances from beautiful ladies and I think, well, personally, right now, let me give you my story. I don't think I'm open as such to a relationship right now.
So in case you're liking Blessing?
No, well, maybe that came out wrong. Not entirely. I'm open, but not entirely. And these are my reasons. I have had a couple of relationships in the past.
I know of one of Blessing's relationships.
The sour ones.
That they broke his heart.
If you cast me here, I'll break everything here.
So I have had
terrible relationships and then, and after the relationship I got to ask myself questions. So I said, okay, where did I go wrong? Where did things go wrong? Then I said, maybe there were things I used to do that I no longer do.
That's how to work on yourself.
Sure, you understand. Okay, maybe there are things I liked or interested that I liked and that got my partner fascinated me.
Yeah.
That I didn't develop or I no longer have, stuff like that. Things that you should ask yourself. So when you are able to attend to yourself, then you can attend to someone else.
Exactly.
And that is why
wisdom.
That is why I said I am not open entirely, because I feel like I'm a work in progress. Fine. And when I said entirely, I am open to someone who can join me in my journey, of course.
Aww.
So that's what I think we should all
say. Your market. Tell them it's open to somebody that can join him in his journey.
Oh my dear. Where
are you joining?
All my DMs are open. No.
Where are you joining to? DM is open. So that's, you can slide. It's slippery. You can slide.
So that's the thing. So if you are considering your type, she's my type. Have you looked to understand or to know if she's really, really, really your type, and if you are a type?
It's not my type.
It's not my type.
Who is your type? What's your type? Are you your type? Are you your type?
But then I would always advise people to go for what they want. That's the main thing here.
Follow your heart.
Your type or not your type. Go for what you want, and at the end of the day, I just hope we are all happy.
Happiness is all that matters. But really, to be truthful, to end this video here, I'm just going to say that before you create a bucket list, make sure that you are a reflection of what you are writing. If you want a hardworking guy, be hardworking. If you want somebody that is dexterous or a business-oriented person, you too, be that thing. Be something that will complement. Yes, he is the breadwinner, but everybody knows that bread is sweeter with butter. Be the butter winner. So compliment this person. You should not be that he is here and you are struggling to even be here. So guys, till I bring you another interesting topic, stay on Everland TV and be rewatching our videos. And don't forget to subscribe, hit the notification bell, like this video because you like it. And follow us on all our social media and Everland TV on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. So I come to your Facebook page. I am Ola. We see every time, anyway. Skeleton, 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 you dey do your body, skeleton, skeleton, skeleton.